Recently, surface exploration studies were completed in an effort to better understand the geothermal resource conditions. Studies suggest that the resource exists outside of the sulfur springs and Piton management areas, much to the relief of St. Lucians.
In the Sufre area, you know that exploration started many years ago. There's a certain amount of cynicism, I think, that attaches itself to any discussion about the possibility of geothermal energy coming out of Sufre. But maybe that cynicism will now start leading to optimism for many different reasons. One, maybe because we won't be drilling in Sufre, we might be drilling somewhere else, but also because of, I think, some of the work that has been done, very positive work, not just at the level of the scientific work in trying to identify the resource, but the very concrete and progressive discussions that have been held between Lucia and OMAT to move this process forward. I'm sure if you do your research on OMAT, you will realize that OMAT is one of the foremost geothermal developers in the world. So we have been very fortunate to have OMAT across the table with us because they have a wealth of experience developing geothermal facilities.
Meetings between Lucia and the proposed geothermal developer to arrive at a consensus regarding the power signing agreement will be held. The development of the geothermal resource is in keeping with the government's policy objective of reducing St. Lucia's dependence on fossil fuels for energy generation.
This takes a lot of negotiating and understanding of the details, understanding of the implications of some of the actions that we're going to take. We are starting off by trying to get a term sheet, which is going to be the forerunner for developing the power purchase agreement, which we normally refer to as a PPA. It is not exciting, so I think the most exciting part is out in the field. This is really tedious work and takes a lot of hours of discussion. The legal people are the ones that are going to draft the document after we've actually ironed out the business terms. So we are still in the process of the discussions.
Government obtained financial assistance and technical export from a number of development partners. The World Bank assisted St. Lucia in accessing approximately US $2 million from the Global Environment Facility, GEF.
At this stage, you never know how much resource you've got until you've drilled, but the indication is it's sufficient for the size of project, as in it's sufficient for St. Lucia's needs. So I think it's a very positive outcome. And I hope the project will move forward on the basis of a strong technical foundation.
Officials sought to put to rest concerns about the project increasing the possibility of earthquakes, saying that there is no need to worry as the project is extremely safe. All told, the project could take a total of 8 to 10 years to complete. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.